Today we're going to talk about how to install the BigTreeTech TMC2208 version 3.0 for UART on the BigTreeTech SKR Pro version 1.1. Now keep in mind these are specifically designed for this board. So we're going to be working with the X stepper, the Y stepper, and the Z stepper. But we also have E0, E1, and E2. And on this board, we have an extra stepper port for the Z axis, which I'm going to remove the jumpers for so we can use it, so that we can use two NEMA 17 stepper motors. So now that that's removed, in order to prepare this for these steppers, we need to remove these jumpers because currently they're being used for SPI. So we're going to pop these out. And if you can't tell, down below here, there is a black set of pins. These are our UART pins for the X, the Y, and the Z. So we're gonna have to put a jumper on those to enable them. Now keep in mind, I purchased the board and steppers with my own money, but I'll be leaving a link in the description for where you can purchase them on Amazon. Now, here is the actual stepper. Now, keep in mind, this is keyed by color, so we have the black side and the red side. That matches up to our board where we have black and red. So we're going to turn it over and just plug it in. We're going to do the same for the next one for our Y stepper. And then following our Z stepper right after that. So we're all set there. Now I'm going to put on heat fins so it can wick away the heat. Now keep in mind, you might want to run a fan on top of this just in case these get a little hot. And there we go. Now in order to load the firmware, we need to pop out the TF drive and insert it into our micro USB adapter. So there we go. And I'm going to pop this into the computer and you may hear a beep. Okay, to start with, what we're going to do is we're going to look at the SD card. And as you can see, it's got firmware in all capital letters. And this is a .cur file or cursor file. So now we're going to go over to Atom with PlatformIO loaded. And I need to tell you something first. As you can see right here, we have the Marlin-bugfix-2.0.x. What I did to get this in here was I downloaded the Marlin firmware from the website, unzipped it, and then went to File, Open Folder for the unzipped folder. So what we're going to do is we're going to expand this folder out. We're going to go to the source folder. Then we're going to go to the core folder. And then we're going to open up boards.h. And what we're going to do is we're going to search on SKR_Pro. And the board that we're looking for is board_BigTree_SKR_Pro_V1_1. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to close out of boards.h and we're going to go back to configuration.h and we're going to do a search on motherboard. And what we currently have is board_ramps_14_EFB. So we're going to paste over that to get the right board type that we're working with.
Then we're going to scroll up and we're going to change define space serial underscore port 0. We're going to change that to a negative 1. Now we're going to search on A4988. And as you can see right here, we have a bunch of different stepper drivers that we can choose from. But we're going to be first removing the comments for the X driver. Then we'll do the Y driver, the Z driver, and for good practice, we'll do E0, which is our first extruder. And now that we have those with the comments removed, we have to change our stepper because this one only does 1/16th of a step, whereas the TMC2208 will do between 1/16th and 1/256th of a step. So we're going to paste that over our X, then our Y, and then finally our Z. Now we're going to do a search on underscore max. And what we're looking for is up here. It's define default underscore axis underscore steps underscore per underscore unit. And this is where we would normally change our values. Right now they're defaulted for the A4988 for the most generic configuration. And keep in mind that these numbers are default setup numbers. If you want the exact ones for your configuration, you're going to have to use the RepRap calculator to find out what these values are. But for this example, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what happens when you're not doing 1/16th of a step. For instance, on our particular stepper that we're working with right now, we can do 1/32nd of a step. So you would change the 80 to 160 if it is a 1/32nd of a step. Now, if it were 1/64th of a step, you'd do 320, which would be doubling of the previous value. But for now, we're not going to worry about that. We're just going to reset it back to what it once was. And we're going to go over to the configuration advanced.h. And we're going to do a search on current underscore x. And apparently we can't find that, so we're going to do a search on 800 and find it that way. So what we have here is our current, or X current, I had it backwards, and that would be our first stepper. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this to 750 just to show you that you can change it. Now you're going to have to consult your data sheet if you're using a different stepper, because the one that I'm using is the BigTreeTech 2208 by TMC, and it's version 3, and I'll leave that in the description so you can see where to find it. And also keep in mind that you may have to change this. It's set to 1/16th of a step. You'd also have to change this if you were to go to 1/32nd. You would change it to 32. 64 if you were to do 1/64th of a step, and so on and so forth. But for now, we're just going to change that back. And we're going to also change the Y to 750 as well. And then we're going to leave the Z alone. And also keep in mind that if you need to compute what the exact value is off your data sheet for your particular NEMA 17 stepper driver, you're going to use the root mean square equation to figure out what that is. So the next thing that I want to show you is I want to show you spread cycle real quick. So I'm going to do a search on Stealth Chop to show you what I'm talking about. And what we have here is the Stealth Chop, which is enabled currently. If you were to remove or add comments, pardon me, it would be automatically spread cycle, which is more powerful but more noisy. So we're going to leave that alone, and we're going to scroll down, and I'm going to show you something here. If you want to do hybrid threshold, which is a combination of Stealth Chop and spread cycle, you would remove the comment, and then when it reaches these thresholds, it would use spread cycle instead of Stealth Chop. But for now, we're going to leave that alone, and we're going to search on monitor underscore driver. And currently, we need to remove the comment for this to set it up, which we've just done. And we're going to now do a search on TMC underscore debug. And this will allow us to use debug commands. So we're going to remove the comment there. Now that we have that all set, what we're going to do is we're going to go over to PlatformIO.ini. This is our configuration file. And we need to change the chipset for our default environment, because currently it's set to the Mega AT Mega 2560, which is not our board type. So we're going to do a search on SKR underscore pro. And we're going to copy BigTree underscore SKR underscore pro. And then we're going to page back up. And we're going to paste that over the Mega AT Mega 2560. Next. Down here, because we have this particular board type, we need to change the TMC stepper at, and then it says greater than 1.0.0. So we need to be able to pull it from online when we compile. So what we're going to do is we're going to add in the following. And so now what we have is the GitHub location for the TMC stepper so that we can actually download it. Now, next, what we're going to do is we're going to compile by using the checkbox over here, and we're going to click save. Okay, now that the compiling has finished, what we're going to do is check to make sure it compiled first by going to toggle build panel. And as you can see, it says success. So we're going to toggle the build panel back. And what we're going to do is we're going to check to see under .pio where it went. So we're going to go to build. And as you can see, there's a BigTree SKR Pro folder. So we're going to open that. And very, very low on the list, we see firmware.bin. So we're going to copy the path. And we're going to go over to run. And we're going to paste the path in and then press enter. And what we have here is our build. So we're going to copy that, or better yet, we're going to go to send, and we're going to send it to the SD card that we looked at just a moment ago. And then we're going to go over to the SD card. And as you can see, we have firmware.bin, which is our compiled version of the firmware.
Okay, off camera, I connected the power for the SKR Pro version 1.1 and also the power for the stepper drivers, and it's unplugged at the moment. So I'm going to put this down for safety. Now the first thing that we need to do is move the jumper to where we can power it via USB. So I'm going to move it over to the next two pins, as you can see right here, and I'm going to remove the SD card and place the TFT drive in the board. Next, I'm going to power it using the USB serial cable. So I'm going to plug in the first half over here and the other half into the computer. And you're going to see a flashing light in the center of the board. That's the firmware loading. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to energize with 12 volts of power. So now that it's plugged in, you don't want to touch the board.
So I'm in the Pronterface folder. I'm going to click on Pronterface. I'm going to connect to the SKR Pro. And as you can see, it says that everything is okay, but we're going to check with the G code being M122 and press enter. And as you can see, it tested okay. So we're going to go over and we're going to move the x-axis 10 millimeters and see what happens. Now we're going to move over and do the y-axis and see what happens. And finally, we're going to move the z-axis 10 millimeters and see what happens there.
So as you can see, it moved much quieter with a higher value for the number of steps for what we left alone. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.